Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're looking at the prize fighter pack from Mystery Ranch, a 21 liter urban styled backpack with solid construction, solid materials, and a really comfortable harness. If you're new to the channel, I'm Ed from Rush Faster, and we do guides and walkthroughs, bring you better gear and better ways to carry. So if you like what you see, please consider subscribing and also hitting that little bell. Let's check out the prize fighter pack from Mystery Ranch. Mystery Ranch is a household name in the carry business. They're based in Montana in the US, and they're known for making some of the world's best specialized backpacks. They're known for their high quality materials and their long lasting construction. And they also have a really solid urban commuting and casual outdoor offering. Today we're looking at the Prize Fighter Pack, which is a 21 liter urban style backpack. If you'd like to see us do more videos on Mystery Ranch packs, please let us know in the comments below. We'd love to hear your feedback. And over the course of this video, if you want to check out the product page of this bag, there is a link in the description below, as well as a little QR code on the screen for you to scan with your phone camera. And if you also want to keep up to date with news in the carry world, we have a Rush Faster Carry Roundup newsletter that you can subscribe to, where we talk about that news and where we also give away some gear to our subscribers every month. So if you'd like to get in on that, be sure to be subscribed to the channel and also to the newsletter. Okay, so starting off with the materials of the prize fighter pack, we have a 500 denier Cordura. As for the hardware, we've got YKK zippers with a polyurethane coating for extra water resistance, and we've also got Duraflex hardware for the buckles. In terms of branding, it's fairly simple. We've just got this one logo patch here at the front. There aren't any other external features on the bag. There are no water bottle pockets or anything like that. If we turn to the harness system here, we have a really comfortable harness system, especially given this bag is a daily backpack at 21 liters. We've got wide, padded, and contoured shoulder straps, which have a plush air mesh wicking underneath to wick away any moisture. The padding on the shoulder straps is very breathable and dense and will prevent the shoulder straps from actually digging into your shoulders, especially if you've got heavier loads in the bag. At the top here, we've got load lifters to allow you to just adjust and tweak your shoulder straps so you can find the best fit on your body when you're carrying it. Further below, we've got an adjustable sternum strap here. It's using a simple Duraflex buckle in the middle. There's no strap management here, so you've got a dangly strap there, just keep that in mind. But you can adjust the position of the sternum strap. You can see there are three points of adjustment here. You simply need to clip off the sternum strap and adjust it to where it best aligns on your body. Further below, we've got simple Duraflex ladder locks here, and again, no strap management, so just keep that in mind. At the back panel, we have an elevated and heavily padded back panel, the same padding on the shoulder straps, that air mesh wicking there. And hopefully you can see on the back panel, it's actually curved here so that it shapes and contours along your back and lower lumbar for the best ergonomic fitting. So you have a really comfortable back panel that'll mold and flex to your back and your shoulders really nicely. And also on the top here, we have a simple grab handle. Now, as we take a look inside the backpack, we've got three compartments that you can store gear inside. Two quick access ones on the front here, and then our main compartment. So this one at the front here on the front face, we've actually got a pretty big stash compartment that goes about halfway inside the bag. So inside there, I've stored some hand sanitizer, just got a cap from Patagonia, an Ozair face mask, my Belroy note sleeve wallet, my Orbit Key key organizer. There's no key leash in this bag for you to securely attach a set of keys on, so I've just put it inside there, and my Leatherman multi-tool. So a lot of space inside this main compartment. You could put a lightweight shell in there if you really wanted to, or you can just put a whole bunch of small snacks, things like that, if you're going on the trail. Next up, we've got a slightly smaller compartment here, which is good for putting smaller bits and pieces that you just want to keep separated from this bigger compartment. Inside, I've got a set of polarized sunglasses from Sunski, and also some truly wireless Bluetooth earphones from Master and Dynamic. Now, typically you'd see this compartment as a fleece lined compartment for those slightly more delicate items like your earphones or your phone, but this is just a simple normal nylon compartment. Getting into the main compartment, we don't have a clamshell opening, but it does open fairly deep so that we can see most of what's inside the compartment. We have these useful paracord loops on the zippers to help us just grab the zippers a bit better. Inside here, I've just stored a Patagonia down jacket, and I've also got a Patagonia torrent shell jacket in its packed form. I've got an Evergoods Civic Access pouch for all of my tech, and then I've got a 20-ounce vacuum insulated water bottle from Stanley. Getting all those bigger items out, you can see that there's this panel here for extra organization, so you can put smaller bits and pieces inside there and organize them however you like. So here we have two medium-sized slip pockets here. I've just got a set of Nomad Kevlar charging cables, and I've also got a portable battery from Nimble. What's really interesting about this battery from Nimble is it's actually made of recycled CDs, which is a really cool program that they've got going on. You should check them out. The links are going to be in the description below. We've also got two slip pockets here for a pen or a stylus. I've just got an Everyman Grafton pen, and I've also got a torch from Olight. Next up, we've got two large slip pockets here. I haven't got anything in this one because it does share the same dimension as these slip pockets there, so you just got to keep that in mind. But on this side, I have a Somewear Labs global hotspot. This provides 100% global satellite coverage, so if you do take this bag on a bit more of a rural and remote hike or anything like that, you can take this with you. This comes with a really friendly app with lots of tracking, and you can do this with other people if you're going on a hike together, things like that. It's a really useful tool. Check them out, Somewear Labs global hotspot. After all that, we've got our devices sleeve. So we've got a tablet sleeve here, which will be able to fit up to most 10-inch tablets. And then we've got our laptop sleeve here, which will fit most 15-inch laptops. Both of these compartments are padded. You can see there's this nice thick padding here for the tablet sleeve, as well as the same thick padding for the laptop sleeve. Inside the tablet sleeve, I've just got an A5 workbook, and both of these sleeves are suspended from the ground. So if you accidentally drop this bag on its base, your devices will be protected because there's an extra buffer of space to absorb the impact. On the sides here, you'll notice there's a little bit of elasticity here just to allow this laptop compartment to stretch and flex. And on the back side of the laptop compartment, you've got the padding from the back panel, but you've also got that plastic frame sheet, which actually keeps the whole bag rigid. Now that we've looked at all the features of the bag, let's conduct our Rush Fast beer capacity test to see how many tinny six packs can fit inside this 21-liter backpack. Let's see that zips up. Oh yeah, it should. There we have it, very snug. 21-liter backpack can fit 4 tinny six packs. Okay, so this is the bag on the body. For your reference, I'm 5'10". Well, everyone, that is the Prize Fighter pack from Mystery Ranch. It is a simple, everyday carry, urban commuting backpack with solid materials, decent organization, and a really comfortable harness system that can be used as a daily driver or even for those slightly more adventurous activities out on the trail. If you're interested in getting the Prize Fighter pack or anything else that you've seen in this video, there are links in the description below. Using any of those affiliate links really do help support the work of the channel at no extra cost to you. And as always, if you want to support us further, you can hit the like button, hit the bell, subscribe to the channel, and also subscribe to the Rush Faster Carry Roundup newsletter. But we'd love to hear your thoughts on this bag. What do you think about the Prize Fighter pack? What do you think about it compared to the typical 3-zip urban assault backpacks? We'd love to hear your thoughts on that. And please do let us know if you'd like to see us do more videos on Mystery Ranch. If you'd like to see more videos like this, then check out some of the links on the screen at the end of this video. But for now, this has been the Prize Fighter pack from Mystery Ranch. Take care, and we'll see you next time.